I had stepped outside to move the rain from the balcony of some government housing. And they must have slipped in. I walked on the outside edge. The look down was sudden death blow. I mean below, but not there, no. I was waiting. Waiting for something. I felt so out of sync, but I was alive as an island that breaks away from the main and spends its life looking for the root. I went in that same apartment where our children were born, and all I could feel was the space. Bodies filled the gap between beats, yeah. It was good. Until I realized that someone else had removed my amp and amplitude and installed their sound. Rugged black like old blues roots to make people say, who built this station? Who built this sound? With whose machines are you looking to be found? They bring drum, they even bring echo chamber. And they set up over my 2-3 tune and radiogram. Well, I started to unplug wire one time. Plug back in mine, take off your sound. Let me come in, let me come in. But in fact, I was feeling their sound. I was feeling it deep in the cage of my soul. So let me extend the metaphor. What was I looking for? The same thing I was looking for, I mean the same sound. All the while it was looking for me. And I realized then that I could either be the river, or that I could step aside and let it flow. Let it flow past, let it flow true. Let it find me.
Several photographs of vintage film of who I taught were my aunt and grandmother.
In their dance of golden green and purple and purple, and all the blinding white of their smiles, their hands with bracelets and fingers twirling in technicolor against board house and incline in 1967 on the valley road, the cocoa rose, the island reel. Long before I had left that house of cut glass and cinnamon, before I had lived in the single room of darkness and obscurity in the house in the sky. Long before this, I was riding across an intersection, swerving to the right and hot against suspense with the breath of engines on my back. Rode on till I was older.
Rode on till I was older.